Welcome to CoreCon today for December 13th, 2019. This is the show where I break down some of the biggest stories happening in the world of CoreCon right now and give you my opinion on them. Now, this is my opinion. If you want to learn more about these stories, check out the show notes down below. I'll pull a link to each story there in the order I talk about them so you can read about them for yourself and come up with your own thoughts. I'd love to hear from you. Now, if you're new here, do me a favor, hit that subscribe button, hit that thumbs up. I'd really appreciate it, because it lets YouTube know you enjoy what we do here, and hopefully we can help you break free from the high cost of cable TV and still watch the shows you enjoy. Well, there's a lot of news to cover today. For a Friday, it was a very busy week in the world of cord cutting, so let's race through it all. But first, for everybody, I know it's a holiday weekend. If you're not here tomorrow, don't forget we are still posting videos on Saturdays with a full week recap, so if you missed anything, make sure to check out our Saturday videos. All right. Jumping into the news of the day, AT&T TV, which is not AT&T TV now. This is the new live TV streaming service with a very similar name, but is a lot more like cable. Requires a physical device from them, requires a two-year commitment, includes fees like broadcast TV, includes price hikes, so that price is only good for the first year, and then it goes up to the second year contract and more. Well, it's been in a few markets. Now we've learned it's going to be nationwide in February of 2020. According to AT&T CEO Jeff McElfresh, I don't know how you say that, I apologize. And he says, hey, February 2020 will be nationwide. And AT&T TV, along with HBO Max, will be what revolutionizes AT&T's TV efforts going forward. Now, there's been some wishful thinking here about AT&T TV. I think a lot of people have hoped that this will bring AT&T back to the early days of DirecTV, where they were being very aggressive and they were offering cool packages and more. I've heard people say, well, you know, yeah, it's got this fee, it's got this device, it's got this contract, but you know, they say that's only, you know, they're evaluating these beta markets. Maybe it'll be different when it goes nationwide. Really caution you against what honestly may be a little bit of wishful thinking. AT&T really doesn't seem to be targeting this towards cord cutters. And I can already hear it. Well, Luke, it's streaming online. Of course it's for cord cutters. Well, not necessarily. AT&T, every time they've talked about it, has talked about it taking DirecTV customers, moving them over because the packages are very similar, but they're much more profitable for AT&T. Why? They don't have to send somebody to your home. They don't have to put a satellite in space. They don't have to install a dish on your home and more. So it's much more profitable for AT&T to offer this AT&T TV package to replace DirecTV eventually. Now their goal is to try to move as many people over to it as possible from UVerse and DirecTV. In markets where AT&T TV is offered, UVerse is no longer offered, for example. So keep that in mind. UVerse is kind of on its dying bed. As AT&T goes national, UVerse will probably die out. So keep that in mind. So if you have AT&T UVerse, what does that mean for you? According to AT&T, nothing. You can continue to use it for now. I'm sure at some point they'll like to pull the plug on that completely. But for now, they're cutting it off to new customers in markets, just to be clear there. So let me know what you think. Does this AT&T TV at all interest you? To me, it really goes down to one thing. Cord cutting is not just about streaming online, right? If it was just about streaming online, then a package like this would be a cord cutting service. To me, a big part of cord cutting is not having contracts. Being a contract-free experience, being able to say, hey, you know, Hulu or YouTube TV or whatever, it may raise your price, I'm out of here. That's the great power of cord cutting. This with a two-year contract, hidden fees, and only a one-year price lock on a two-year contract, that to me is not cord cutting. So let me know what you think. All right, there's been a lot of talk about piracy, IPTV, and account sharing in 2019. Now, according to research from Parks Associates, these IPTV, piracy, and account sharing is costing content owners over $9.1 billion in 2019, and they estimate that's going to go up to $12.5 billion. Now, I hear the arguments already. I can see you typing them. Well, Luke, that assumes everybody who wanted that or used piracy or used account sharing would have paid for it. And yeah, you are right, there are some truth in that. But at the same time, a good chunk of them would. This idea that everybody wouldn't, that has a piracy service, or everybody who has password sharing, would suddenly just stop watching it if it wasn't available illegally, I think is a little bit overly estimating what that would be. Now, could it be a little bit lower? Sure. But I do find it very interesting. And when you see numbers like 9.1 billion, you can see why Spectrum is trying to crack down on password sharing. You see why Dish is going on a warpath suing every IPTV company, reseller, anyone they can get their hands on going forward, and more. And you can see why they're funding Ace and more. Honestly, for companies like Dish, who has lawyers on staff that just sit there on a salary, probably doesn't really cost them a lot to go after these people in the grand scheme of things. Yeah, there's some cost, but it's very minor compared to any possible return on it. So let me know, what do you think about $9.1 billion with a B dollars being lost to piracy in 2019? This comes from Parks Associates, fairly well-respected research group there, so keep that in mind. All right, are you still paying Spectrum for TV because you just want to have NFL red zone, outdoor, or Major League Baseball strike zone? I got bad news for you. You're about to pay more. So Spectrum has started to notify TV customers that at the end of December, NFL red zone, outdoor, and MLB strike zone will be moving to their sports add-on. Currently, I believe it's the gold package and higher. You have those channels included in your TV package. Going forward, unfortunately, you're going to have to start paying more for that, because they are no longer going to be included with your TV packages. So bad news there, but the good news is if you're a cord cutter, you're saving even more money. You know, NFL Red Zone is currently available on Sling and Fubo TV. Strike Zone is on Sling. I believe it's somewhere else. Leave me a comment. Remind me what other service has MLB. Strike Zone, Outdoor Networks on a few. There, you know, if you got those, your price isn't changing right now, but you're about to pay more for Spectrum to get their new sports TV package. So let me know. Are you still a Spectrum's customer because you're like, hey, I really wanted to get this channel. You know, it's in this bundle. It's expensive, but I have it all in one place. What do you think about the price hike? Spectrum just raised their price back in October. Now this is effectively a hidden price hike. They're saying, hey, guess what? We're taking channels away, moving them to more expensive add-ons, and you still have to pay the same amount of money. So not great news for Spectrum customers. Good news is cord cutting would love to have you. If you think about cutting the cord, this may be the time to do it. And let me know. Let me know what you think of these hidden price hikes. We're seeing them more often. Comcast moved, turn classic movies up, dropping stars from some packages, and more. So leave me a comment, let me know. Have you ever wondered how much money Roku gets for when you see a full takeover ad? Your home screen suddenly recently was all themed Disney Plus for a while, the big Disney Plus logo and more. Or how much Roku gets for those quick launch buttons on your remote that say Netflix, Hulu, Amazon, and more. Well, according to a Bloomberg study, which got numbers from eMarketer, Roku gets $1 million per ad screen takeover, I'm assuming that's per day, and gets $1 per Roku unit sold for each quick launch button. So that $30 Roku Express is really $34 when you consider the fact that they're getting $4 for the different buttons on there. And every time Roku sells a full home screen takeover ad, which you can disable, they get $1 million. That's how Roku is able to keep their price so low and sell a 4K streaming player for under $50 or sell an HD one for under $30. But let me know, what do you think of that? Are you happy? Like, hey, I got these buttons. Maybe they're useful, maybe they're not. But I saved $4 when I bought this streaming player versus the other way. You probably saved more because Roku's number one revenue source now is ads, which include the home screen takeovers, which I would include the quick launch buttons, and subscriptions. They make far more money on that than they do on physically selling Rokus. Very much like the Google model of, hey, we're going to give you all this stuff for free. We'll make the money in the ads, etc. So let me know what you think of that. But very interesting story. If you want to check that out, look at the show notes down below. It's really interesting read to look at Roku's growth there with making money on that. All right, next story up, Vudu is now offering refunds if you don't like the movie. If you rent a movie in the first 30 minutes, you say, this was not a good spend of money. Vudu will now give you a credit back for that movie so you can go buy another movie to watch. Really great. Audible has been doing this for a little while. I think I've only ever done that once with Audible, but if you start to read a book and you're like, this isn't great, you can return it and exchange it, get your money back, and get a different book. It's not cash back, but it's a credit towards a different book. Now Vudu is doing that. They're also launching a price match. So if you find a better deal on a movie or on a rental somewhere, Vudu says they're going to price match that. So if you're not using Vudu, it may be time to check them out. I really love this idea. I mean, how many times have you ever looked at a movie and said, that sounds good. Do I really want to spend $3 on that? It sounds interesting. I may want to rent it. May not. What happens if I regret it? Well, now you say, hey, if I start it in the first 30 minutes, it's not great, I'm returning it. I'm going to get a different movie. So let me know. You think that's good or bad? And if you're not using Vudu, will this get you to try Vudu? Let me know. All right. AT&T TV now is adding NBA League Pass. You can now subscribe to NBA League Pass inside the AT&T TV Now app, which will allow you to manage your subscription from multiple places in a single service. And it also means your national games are airing on NBA TV or are airing on ESPN, ABC, and more can appear right next to all the NBA League Pass games for your out-of-market games. NBA League Pass gives you access to out-of-market games, not in-market, not actually aired games, but out-of-market games. It's $40 a month, not a bad deal if you're a huge NBA fan and you have AT&T TV. Now, you can just have it all in a single spot, one unified user interface. This comes after AT&T added NBA TV to some lower packages. I can't remember how far down it goes. I know it's in the Go Big. I think it went down to the second highest package on AT&T's TV Now's grandfathered plans. So good news, if you are an AT&T TV customer, you wanted this, you don't need a second app. I love the ability to just jump back and forth between different games. If I'm watching a game on ESPN, but I hear there's a big upset happening, I'm an NBA League Pass, I can quickly jump over that and go back and forth without needing to exit the NBA League Pass app, go to the DirecTV Now app, exile that, go back to the NBA TV app, and more. So that's a pretty cool addition there. All right, if you use the HD Home Run to manage your antenna, it's a great streaming device that will take your antenna and stream it out to Roku's, Fire TVs, and more. Well, they're rolling out a brand new redesigned live TV user interface for antennas, and it's a huge improvement over the older version. Now, one caveat here, it's not everything about Roku. They say Roku is a little bit different of a beast. They just launched their Roku channel. They still need to update that, but all the others are being updated. So leave me a comment and let me know if you are a customer for that, if you enjoyed it or not. Let me know. I'll love to hear from you. Hulu is launching a binge-friendly ad experience, which will allow you to stream shows ad-free. So they're going to give you an option to watch a ad earlier on in the show, where you can watch one longer ad that's been specifically paired to that Roku or to that show so that you can binge watch through multiple episodes without having to be stopped quite as often. So maybe if you're willing to watch a longer ad about Cheez-Its or something at the beginning of a show, then you'll be able to watch the rest of the show pretty much ad-free. So let me know what you think of these ideas. Now this isn't necessarily new. I believe Hulu's done this in the past where it was like, hey, pick one of these two ads, and if you want to watch this longer ad cut here, the rest of the show will be free. I remember them doing that in the past. This seems to be the next generation of that, where they're more targeting it. And Cheez-It Snapped is one of the premier partners of this, where they'll be like, hey, here's a long Cheez-It Snapped one. Don't you want to eat some Cheez-Its as you watch this binge watch of whatever show on Hulu you're watching? So let me know what you think of that. Is that something you're interested in, or you find that annoying? So that's it for today. I hope you all had a fantastic week. Hope you have a great holiday weekend. I know everybody's busy trying to shop for holiday presents, go all their way to go get ready for the weekend. Don't forget we're here tomorrow. And if you're new here, hit that subscribe button, hit that thumbs up. If you're a regular, don't forget to ring the notification bell so you don't miss any of these videos. And I'll be back tomorrow with more cord cutting news, tips, tricks, and reviews. And a special welcome to all the new viewers here. So many new subscribers. 130,000 subscribers. That's absolutely mind-boggling to me. So thank you so much for your support. I really appreciate it. We'll be back tomorrow. We'll see you real soon.